Good evening, everyone. This is Royce Miller coming back at you with yet another Let's Try. And tonight on the docket, give me back that Filet'o'Fish. Give me back that Filet'o'Fish. Give me that fish. Give me back that Filet'o'Fish. Give me that fish. Yep, that's right. We're going to McDonald's to try the other thing that I've never gotten to try from that restaurant. Like, you might think it's weird that all the times I've eaten at McDonald's throughout my entire life, all 30 years, I've never tried their one fish item. But, like, here's the thing. I'm a creature of habit. I ate chicken nuggets until I was in, like, 7th or 8th grade. And then I finally discovered that, oh, hey, I actually kind of like their cheeseburgers. Just without those awful onions on them. And then in high school, that's when they did the Angus Third Pounders that I loved. And then, oh, their premium chicken filet sandwich was also fantastic. Mmm. Oh, and then I also did, like, their salads back when Finding Nemo came out. I told that story before. But never once have I had the inkling to try their fish. And today, we correct that. So, without further ado, the Filet'o'Fish. Now, arguably, I should have waited until Lent to try this, because, again, this is their Lent offering. But, like, it's a year-round thing, and I'm like, well, I just tried the thing, I may as well do their other, like, really interesting item that's unlike anything else on their menu. So let's just take a peek under the hood here and show you what we're working with. Ooh. A very mayonnaise heavy tartar sauce, a very small fish patty, and underneath, half a slice of cheese. You don't even get a full slice of this sandwich. Now I can see kind of why it's a very small piece of meat. But without further ado, 30 years in the making. Here we go. This looks to be a tempura batter. It is a fish sandwich. Honestly, it's just a good fish sandwich. Color me shocked. I should preface this, though, that, like, most of the time I have fish of this quality, it's baked because, like, you know, like, I bake fish sticks. I bake fish fingers. This benefits heavily from the fact that it's deep fried. And then you have this lovely soft bun. This might actually be a potato bun. It's a little sweeter than their normal bread items. But that could just be perception. The tartar sauce is fine. Like, I don't like tartar sauce traditionally because it's just mayonnaise and relish, and I don't like relish. But as I've grown older, I've tried to expand my palate, and sometimes that includes, you know, trying to enjoy things that you don't normally enjoy. And in this case, it's relish. I actually think it's funny. People like to talk smack about mayonnaise, but they like tartar sauce, they like aioli, they like, you know, the Thousand Island sauce. All variations of mayonnaise. Mayonnaise is kind of like corn in that it's in way more products than you think it is. Thank you. darn. Here I was hoping that I would finally have something that would taste gross. Because, like, McDonald's fish sandwich. That shouldn't work. You know. That should be a recipe for food poisoning. But here's the thing. My idiot brain doesn't process, like, oh, wait, this is McDonald's, the most famous food, you know, famous fast food chain around the globe. Of course they would have making their fish sandwich down to a science. Literally down to how much cheese is on it. Like, someone made the decision that that sandwich only needed half a slice of cheese. And yes, you know me too well. Boo, gotta pad out the video somehow, right? I do believe that the Filet'o'Fish is often added to the 2-for-5 menu as well, because, like, it's not their big selling item. You know, like, that's usually their burgers, because they're a burger chain. Fun fact, Australia calls hot sandwiches, like fried chicken sandwiches or fish sandwiches, burgers. Which is weird because, like, burger refers to hamburger, which is just ground beef. But, like, it shouldn't really matter because, like, a hamburger is a sandwich. Although that's contentious to some people. Some people think that a hot dog isn't a sandwich. Some people think that a burger isn't a sandwich. Just, like, what is a sandwich to you guys, huh? Like, what is the exact definition? Because, like, a hot dog is just a bologna sandwich on a submarine roll. I'll say, knock on wood. I'm sorry. Most impressive thing about this so far? No bones. Bones are a thing I have to worry about a lot in fish stuff, especially cheap fish stuff. Although, this might be that very processed fish, and they just made it look flaky. Because, like, if you look at it, it does kind of look pretty flaky like a normal fish fillet, but somehow I doubt that it's actual fish fillet. I don't know how true this is, but I also heard that, like, McDonald's has to keep changing which fish this is made out of because they overfish to the point of near extinction whenever they have a different fish or whenever they change fish. But that sounds like an urban legend to me. Sorry. I do love fish. I worry that my body can't process fish because, like, anytime I have a lot of fish, my pee smells like fish oil. Like, I get a major fish stank when I pee after eating, like, a ton of calamari or shrimp or something. And I'm worried that, like, maybe my body can't process omega-3 or something. Like, but sometimes, you know, just, like, eating stuff can flavor your bodily secretions. My grandpa, back in the 80s, used to take garlic, which was supposed to be a vitamin supplement. And my mom used to tell horror stories about how it would make him, like, practically sweat garlic. Which is very weird to think about. Like, someone just taking a vitamin and stinking like cheap Italian food. Not like real garlic, just like garlic powder or something. I don't know. Speaking of my grandpa, I think I'll finish off today by telling y'all a little story that I've never really told. And it's fascinating to me personally because, like, I've never heard, like, this is one of those things that only, that you can't really back up. But, well, you might be able to back up just by verifying with the National Guard in that area. But anyway, eighth grade, I think 2008, I believe this was right before my parents got divorced. My grandparents and I were in Chamberlain, South Dakota. And we were going to fish on the Missouri River. And we, so we set up all of our lines. And then my cousin and my two cousins and I were splashing around in the river too while our Grandpa George was kind of manning the lines and fishing. Didn't get a single bite that day, of course. When all of a sudden we see this thing coming down the river toward us, and we look at it and it's this weird, green painted boat. It starts approaching our location, and Grandpa George immediately starts reeling in the fishing lines, like, rah, rah, you know, grumbling the whole way. And it's full of soldiers. They come up onto the beach, and we realize that it's not a boat. It's an amphibious vehicle. And I was amazed. Like, I'd never seen anything like this before. And this was just a National Guard exercise, it turns out. Like, my grandparents talked to them a little bit. It was pretty cool. My cousins and I were in our swim trunks just eating salami and mustard sandwiches from the picnic. Well, the cooler that Grandma had packed. While these soldier dudes were, you know, doing their drills and stuff. It was a really fun time. I miss that old bastard sometimes. My grandpa passed away in 2018. So, let's see. January 2018. My grandpa dies. My workplace floods due to a burst pipe. And I am dealing with undiagnosed depression. It was probably an ATL for me. Oh, and I also watched Devilman Crybaby at the time, which is a really dark anime, and not one you should watch when you're in the headspace I was in. In fact, honestly, you shouldn't watch it at all. It's a bad anime. Anyway, God rest you. Yeah, I just realized that my grandpa never met me, like, after I started taking medication and arguably became a better person. That realization just hit me. Well, y'all have a good one. This is Royce Miller. I'm sorry for ending on a downer like that, but y'all have a good one. I'm outie.